every right to be angry. Please, Steve, yesterday was a day from hell.
You had a day from hell. John Paul was that traumatised that he went to the police to take his statement back. Right, do you want to know why he did that? Because he didn't want to be humiliated in court again just because of Finn's lies.
I'm sorry, all right? I shouldn't have said what I did.
And if you want to go around being the morality police, you want to get your facts straight first.
Steve, I saw you kissing George by the fountain.
No, you saw him get too overexcited and me push him away.
You told me you cheated. I might have got the wrong person, but...
Whether you got the right person or the wrong person, Tony, I trusted you. Right, I confide in you, and then you go and betray me.
But maybe if I speak to John Paul...
No, it's too late. Because the wedding's off. So that's my best mate and my boyfriend down the toilet, all because of you.
But I need you to get rid of it, Jim. Crushed.
You, with me, now.
Steve, I'm so sorry about yesterday.
Well, you need to come and tell John Paul that, then.
No, I need George here with me.
John Paul knows.
Tony is going to blurt it out. Look, I am not having him finish me over this, so we go and find him and you tell him the truth. Please, George, I need your help.
I can't leave Esther.
Esther will be just fine.
What?
Don't you goldfish understand English now, Scram?
Come on.
I don't want to miss George.
George?
Yes, I couldn't sleep last night, you know, tossing and turning, thinking about it, so I decided to go around there.
What is it with George? Is that some kind of man magnet or something?
John Paul, open the door. Look, I know you're in there. I've got someone here that wants to talk to you.
I think you forgot your toothbrush. You go get that.
John Paul.
You've got 1 minute.
Phoebe, I don't know what John Paul's told you about me and Steve, but...
Steve? He's a guy in the club.
No, tell John Paul.
I don't know why Tony would have said that about me and Steve, but it's just not true.
But what he's trying to say is, it was a stupid, drunken kiss, right? Nothing more.
Less than nothing.
Is that it? You're quite finished, yeah?
Go on.
No. Right, do you really think in a million years I'd ever go back there?
Thanks.
I'm sick of your excuses. Just... I'm done, okay?
Vince, what are you doing here?
Wait. What can I get you? We haven't picked yet. Oh, OK, we'll just give us a shout when you're ready. Hey, she ripped into John Paul yesterday, outside the court, accusing him of being a pedo. Surprised she's got the nerve to show her face. Sorry, what was that? Oh, nothing. Can't you say it to me face? Well, I was just saying, I'm surprised to see you after showing yourself up yesterday.
Oh, so you think sticking up for my abuse, son, is something to be ashamed of?
Well, it's a bit...
Well, maybe you want to take your custom elsewhere.
What's going on?
Nothing, I just...
I'm sorry, I just can't do this.
Hey, Diane, wait.
I wants to make a cake for Finn when he comes home for the weekend, but... I can't remember his favourite, whether it was strawberry jam or chocolate.
I put that down for a second.
And when he was younger, he used to love jam. But he got more around his face than on his toast.
Please. But Leela had no right to say those things. It was really hurtful.
Yeah. And you could have stuck up for me.
Hey, that restaurant's our livelihood. I've got a responsibility to see to make sure...
Oh, what about your responsibility to me? Are you supporting me?
Yeah, I love you. I'd do anything to protect you.
So why does it feel like you're on their side? Hey, all this worrying about Steve and sipping champagne with John Paul.
Sorry, I never meant to hurt you.
Look, I know how hard it is, okay, with Finn coming out with all these things now. And I know how it must look. I am not stupid. But I'm his mum. And if he can't rely on me, then he's got no one. Does that make me a bad person?
No, of course it doesn't.
I know you want to do the right thing by Steve, but trying to keep everyone happy, it just means that I can never be sure that you're behind me. Do you know, I feel so alone in all this. And I need you, Tony. I need to know that you're in my corner.
Phoebe, I don't get it. I mean, you must have known and you said nothing.
Last night was the first time he mentioned anything about a drunken snog.
I mean, George, I don't understand.
You don't understand because it's not true. George sleeping with someone is a big deal. And, well, he would have told me.
What about all that stuff that Tony said?
Even friends say and do a lot of things that they don't mean. For all sorts of reasons.
Sweetheart, are you okay?
Yeah. I've got to go. John Paul, you found someone that you love who loves you back. Don't let so much stupid Tony says take that away from you.
What? So I didn't expect.
Can I come in?
Yeah. A little bit of a mess. I was just trying to find something to watch. Ended up trying to read this.
I'm sorry.
You? You're sorry.
I overreacted. Just hearing Diane make all those accusations yesterday, I didn't think that things could get any worse.
I'm sorry.
Look, if I'm going to get through this trial, then I need people around me that I can depend on.
You can depend on me? Look, I swear, John Paul, I love you so much.
And the fighting with Tony, I mean, that has to stop.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll do anything.
And you definitely didn't sleep with George, did you?
Well, absolutely, I did not.
Because that changes everything, you know that.
I know.
It's just, with everything that's going on at the moment, I really need you to be honest with me.
You can trust me. Okay?
Okay. Come here.
So, does this mean that the engagement's back on?
I love you. But let's wait till after the trial before we make any big promises, yeah?
Tony. Right, me and John Paul, we've had a talk. We've sorted some things out and we decided we don't want to fight anymore.
No?
And I know we're in the middle of this messy war thing, but when we step in here, it should be like Switzerland.
Switzerland, eh?
Well, you know what I mean? Like, neutral. No more fighting.
Yeah, well, it's a nice idea, but it's never gonna happen.
Why? I thought that's what we wanted.
Diane needs to know how much I love her, and that means not being around you.
We work together.
Not anymore. From now on, I'm gonna do separate shifts. If you've got a question or there's a problem, you speak to Cameron, he can pass it on.
Well, I came here to see you because I thought we could work this out.
Yeah, you thought wrong. Next time I lay eyes on you, it's gonna be in that courtroom.